everyone, Chloe here, and welcome back to my channel. And if you are new here, ladies and lurkers, welcome. So as promised, today's video is all about a very common affliction with all races and classes of men that is otherwise known as the Peter Pan syndrome. Now, the Peter Pan syndrome gets its name from the fictional character Peter Pan that was created by novelist and playwright James Matthew Barry about a free-spirited but mischievous young boy who can fly but who never wants to grow up. And the Peter Pan syndrome, based on that character, are men who basically fear the responsibility of manhood. Now, to have this syndrome does not automatically mean that this very common man-child is mentally ill or has narcissistic personality disorder, which is a medical term that is flung around way too casually, because narcissism is a spectrum disorder that affects both men and women equally. But the Peter Pan syndrome is more about a man's inclination in becoming addicted to immaturity, particularly when it is modeled to them by their fathers or by the absence of their fathers, or when they are overly mollycoddled by the women in their families, namely their mothers, grandmothers, and sisters. And when male children or male boys are spoiled by the women in their family, those boys often evolve into men who grow up with the misogynistic expectation that women are solely created to serve a man's needs, and that a good wife and mother or girlfriend or life partner is that of an enabler. The Peter Pan syndrome is a man who is a master of stunted emotional growth and silliness and unmanliness, and he will do anything to avoid the maturity that comes with the reality of responsibility by rejecting all things adult. So through the lens of Mr. Peter Pan, when he is in need of a woman, he is in essence in need of a mommy. So here are the 10 signs of an immature Peter Pan. At number 10, they are men who are typically spongers, who expect a free ride from the responsible women in their lives. At number 9, they are men who are typically only attracted to masculine givers, who are willing to do all of the heavy lifting in all aspects of the relationship. At number 8, they are blamers. Men who suffer with the Peter Pan syndrome will typically blame the entire world for their low value aspirations, their low value production, their low value predicament, and their lack of a respectable standing in society. Because Mr. Peter Pan typically lacks the insight that is required for maturity and growth. At number 7, when older, between the ages of 25 and 85, they are typically very entrenched and invested in a thick layer of narcissism and their very low opinions of women. At number 6, a man with the Peter Pan syndrome will conveniently forget important holidays, namely your birthday and or your anniversary, in order to condition you out of having any expectations out of them. Number 5, they are typically very selfish, me, 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 and lazy lovers, and do not believe in the maturity of foreplay. Number 4, if they've ignored your feelings or your hurt feelings, they typically will respond to your dismay and your disappointment with indifference. Number 3, the Peter Pan Dusty has an inflexible mindset and will typically not listen to opinions that differ from his own, because his mindset is often rigid and narrow. Number 2, the Peter Pan archetype is a low self-worth and low self-esteem man who covers and distorts his low value offerings with smugness and arrogance, which are often used as a mask for fake confidence. And number 1, the Peter Pan Dusty will never say I'm sorry or have the ability to make amends for his misgivings, because Mr. Peter Pan is an emotional child trapped inside of an adult body. Now, who are your average Peter Pans in the world? A Peter Pan is the living embodiment, boyhood fairy tale of youthfulness and playfulness, who is energized by the delusion of the forever fountain of youth. And the women's version of Mr. Peter Pan is the Cinderella complex, and both the Peter Pan syndrome and the Cinderella complex are toxic mindset afflictions where they both expect to be rescued and babied by mature adults. Now, Mr. Peter Pan is full of contradictions and conflicts and the spirit of confusion, because Mr. Peter Pan is the man who brings to your doorstep an abundance of identity identity crises due to his whimsical and magical fairy tale thinking that has nothing to do with the reality of the payoff of maturity and focus and persistence and hard work and sacrifice and building trust and becoming a respected leader, provider, and protector, because he is responsibility avoidant. These are men who typically still live at home, that live hand to mouth, and their financial resources typically come from the women in their lives, namely mom, grandmom, and sister, then eventually from girlfriend to wife. And when it comes to money, Mr. Peter Pan is also very stingy and ungenerous because on the inside, he has chosen the immaturity of a child who selfishly feels entitled to not share, as he views women in their ideal role as masculine givers, while the man-child, Mr. Peter Pan, gets to be a feminine receiver. And when Mr. Peter Pan does not get his way, just like a child, they are prone to acting out and having temper tantrums and will fly into fits of entitlement and narcissistic rage when they do not get their way, which can be very intimidating to a woman with low self-worth and low self-esteem. And if Mr. Peter Pan does find true love, they will always grind it into the ground. They will take it for granted because they will always lack the give and take of maturity that comes with reciprocity. Now, avoiding these types of men at all costs will at first glance appear to be simples, but Mr. Peter Pan is very good at the confidence game of selling you lies and promises and, more importantly, trust. But in all exchanges of seduction, when first meeting someone, both men and women are typically inclined to show their best face, their best attributes, and to only highlight their positives that come with their representative until the mask of deception eventually falls off. Which is why a woman should always protect her virtue until a man has earned her trust. But the Peter Pan types are typically drawn to women that are fixers and mother figure types and codependent women and natural givers and women who value mothering over their femininity and their womanhood. And otherwise, very compassionate, highly tolerant, and patient people with a humanitarian nature who tend to see the potential and the good in all human beings. These are the women who are inclined to be empaths, who often lack boundaries, and who have the disease to please, and who naively believe that love and niceness will conquer all. But in essence, women who are attracted to Mr. Peter Pan are typically strong mother figures and are masculine giving women who love to feel needed, because feeling needed gives her a distorted sense of strength. But as with all role reversal arrangements, they are bound to backfire, as Mr. Peter Pan is a child of rebellion who is not interested in being trapped or put on a leash by his domineering and often nagging strong mother figure. And these relationships will generally implode, as the mommy archetype will generally turn into the nagging, depressed woman who refuses to leave and who refuses to fix her own low self-esteem issues. But more importantly, Mr. Peter Pan knows that she isn't going anywhere because of her codependent addiction to putting his needs ahead of her own. Now, when you are in a relationship with Mr. Peter Pan, he may initially begin to draw you in with his macho-ness and his grandiose arrogance mixed with good old-fashioned flattery and his usual tear-jerking pity story of having no one to care. But you will soon find yourself in a nasty, parasitical entanglement / attachment of frustration, and you will be guilted into the bullseye storm of their low self-esteem and working overtime to keep this toxically a one-sided high maintenance dynamic from veering off of the rails. Now, a woman who is in her feminine as a receiver may have a little fun with Mr. Energy Zapper, because they are men who can temporarily be exciting and lighthearted and playful. But a feminine woman will never stick around for the long haul with Mr. Peter Pan, because for her, he is a fun toy. But Mr. Peter Pan is a lock and key match made in heaven for the insecure dust bunny or the take charge boss woman who hides her insecurity with the coverings of her success. And she is the woman who more than likely will become his ride or die, role reversal wife. As an adult, Mr. Peter Pan will often turn into the sexually and financially frustrated reject and chauvinist and misogynistic adult in order to mask his ever-deepening inadequacies and the insecurities that are sure to come from being dumped and left behind by a woman who once believed in the hopes and the pipe dreams of their potential. And Mr. Peter Pan will forever be the man-child who will have a shoddy, shaky, and inconsistent work history that will reflect a man who will work overtime in strategizing how to do the least. These men can be very self-centered to the point of cruelty, and their life goals will always be fuzzy, poorly defined, unfocused, and are full of procrastination. So how do you teach Mr. Peter Pan a lesson? By walking away with your life intact and allowing him to feel the burn and the pain of not being enabled. Because that is the only way that a toxically immature man or immature woman can snap out of the daydream of living in Never Never Land. So that is all that I have to say on this for now. The Peter Pan archetype is as common a dusty as a summer housefly, as many modern men are being conditioned to embrace the extended childhood mindset of believing that they will be young forever. That is, until father time comes for us all. Now, for the ladies and lurkers and the ear hustlers who are listening, I never fall for a man's victim narrative of needing a strong and powerful woman to take charge, because what he is really telling you is that he wants a do-it-all mother and father figure who will work her fingers to the bone to protect him from the reality of maturity and adulthood. So, ladies and lurkers, have you ever met Mr. Peter Pan, or have the men in your family been groomed to be the Peter Pan archetype? Leave your thoughts on this common anti-seductive dusty below, and stay tuned for more feminine content to come, and I will catch up with you ladies and you lurkers in the next one.